Hey, hope everybody's having an absolute amazing day. I'm sitting up here in Oklahoma getting ready to preach tonight at the Gate Revival Hub in Cushing, Oklahoma. It's between Oklahoma City and Tulsa. And I'm just up here and I've been into the Word and I've been reading a passage that I've been reading and going over for a few months, but I'm talking this passage has got me stirred up, okay? This is Matthew 9, 35 through 38, and we're going to go over to Matthew 10 and 1, okay? I'm going to talk about your imparted authority. Let's start off in Matthew 9, 35. Jesus walked through the region with a joyful message of God's kingdom realm. Right there, it said Jesus, he's happy, y'all. Jesus is happy because he's talking about God's kingdom realm. He's talking about the Father's business, and he's excited because he's preaching and teaching on the kingdom of God. That is the lost message of the church, if you want to know the truth. But Jesus is happy. He's preaching and teaching about his Father's kingdom. And then it said he taught in their meeting houses, and wherever he went, he demonstrated God's power by healing every type of sickness and disease. But when he saw the vast crowds of people, Jesus' heart was deeply moved with compassion because they seemed weary and helpless. Check this out. Jesus was preaching in all the churches, all the temples, all the synagogues, all the tabernacles, all the house meetings, but the people were weary. Because nobody was preaching and teaching the kingdom of God. They were teaching dry, dead religion, kind of like a lot of the American churches today. But then he turned to his disciples and said, guys, the harvest is huge and ripe, but there's not enough harvesters to bring it all in. As you go, plead with the owners of the harvest to thrust out many more reapers to harvest this grain. So he's telling them, guys, there is a vast harvest out there, but nobody is walking as happy as Jesus was, preaching and teaching on the kingdom of God. This is where Jesus, his joy came from. What I just read you in Matthew 9:35, it said that he had a joyful message. He was happy because he was teaching the kingdom. But then he looked at his disciples and said, we gotta have more workers. And then let's go over to Matthew 10 and 1. And it said, Jesus gathered his 12 disciples and he imparted to them authority to cast out demons and to heal every sickness and every disease. Now, this is what happened. The disciples were not begging for an open door. They were not begging Jesus to fill up their itinerary. They were walking with Jesus. They were walking around with him. They were seeking him. They were seeking him daily. They were close to him. He saw that they were then ready. He saw that where they were at with their gift mix, with their character and integrity and their knowledge, he saw that it meted a need in a region. He said, I'm going to get where you are with me and my Father. I'm going to marry it to the region and to the need that is there. He put them together, and therefore, there's where the apostles were sent out. So what Jesus said was, come here, 12. I'm going to impart to you authority from me, from the kingdom of God. I'm going to impart it into your life. And then you are going to go out into the region. And what you've been following me doing for years, you've seen me go into the temples, the house meetings, the tabernacles. You've seen me rebuke the Pharisees. You've seen me heal the leper. You've seen me teach the word of God, preach the word of God. Now you are going to go out and you're going to do the same thing. You no longer will just be a follower of me, but you will not just be a hearer of the word, but you will be a doer of the word. Now you are about to carry out your kingdom assignment. And I really felt the Lord wanted me to speak on this afternoon in Oklahoma. Like I said, tonight we're going to be at the Gate Revival Hub with Apostle Jeannie and Doug Cooper. We're going to have so much fun. But what you must understand is that you, when you walk with God, when you are at that place, the Lord is going to elevate you in his timing. When he sees that your character is in the right place, your integrity is in the right place, and then he sees that what you've done with your gift, you have worked on your gift, you've studied, you've been cultivating the gift, you've been in the Word of God, you've been reading the Word of God, you know the Word of God, you've been devouring the Word of God, you've been spending time in prayer, you've been spending that extra time with him. He sees all of that. And then he sees the cries of his people. Just think about Brother Moses. Moses was over here on the backside of the desert. But he heard the cries and the oppression of his people. So he put an anointing and a grace upon Moses to go set these people free. He imparted kingdom authority. You got that? You can be the answer to somebody else's cry that is oppressed. Somebody is crying out right now, and God is preparing you to give you authority, to give you a strong impartation. And in this strong impartation, he is going to summon you like he did the disciples. Y'all come over here. He pulled them away. He's going to pull you away. He is going to impart to you wisdom, knowledge, and understanding that is far beyond the earthly realm. And then he's going to send you out into a harvest, because he sees that there is a harvest with out workers. There's no shepherds. The people are weary. They're crying out for something. And the Lord is going to anoint you. So you are about to walk into a season when the anointing of God is going to come upon you. You are going to have the kingdom of God imparted into you. You know, it says in Luke 17 that the kingdom of God is within us. The Lord is going to just have just the Holy Spirit just breathe wind upon you. And this is going to be the time that you are about to start flowing. Some of you have been sitting on the backside of a desert. You've been out in your wilderness. You've been hiding in your cave season. And the whole time that you're there, oh, I hope somebody's getting this. The whole time that you've been there, God has been cultivating a work in your heart, because he's about to call you forth to answer the call to go forth for the kingdom of God. For the kingdom of God is at hand. And God is just looking for people that he can anoint right now. People to walk in great signs, wonders, and miracles. To preach messages that have never been heard before. To just walk with amazing power. These are people that are full of character. These are people that are full of integrity. These are people that will not that look for the spotlight for themselves, but they will point everything back to the Lord, because the Lord all God mighty says that he is a jealous God, and he shares his glory with no man. I'm telling you, my friends, this is a season that you are about to get kingdom authority imparted into your life, and you are going to understand why you've went through everything that you've went through. I'm telling you, you're going to be able to look back at your past and say, oh, that's why I was removed from this church. That's why they did me dirty. That's why I was kicked out of that group. That's why they ran me off. That's why that Facebook group blocked me off. That's why nobody wants anything to do with me, because I had to be alone with him, because he called me. He is the wooer of my soul, and he called me in because he needed to impart something into me. That you can't get that full impartation while you're sitting there talking to everybody else. If you're always the down person, the one that's always ready to hang out with everybody, you're not going to get the full impartation, because he needs you by yourself. He needs you in that prayer room. He needs you living that Matthew 6:6 lifestyle, that life of seeking him early in the morning, Mark 1:35, the Mark 6:46, go away late at night just to spend some time with the Father. And when he knows that he has you in that right place, and he is developing you by the school of the Holy Spirit, and the lead instructor is the Holy Spirit. See, what you got to understand is, as long as you will be a forever student, Jesus will be the forever teacher. But whenever you think that you don't need him anymore, and then all of a sudden that he can't teach you because you're unteachable, but the forever teacher is looking for the forever student to walk hand in hand, because there are messages that are in heaven that nobody's preached yet. There are worship songs in heaven that no one's even tapped into. There is a greater miracle. There is a greater apostolic prophetic grace about to hit the body of Christ than we've ever even seen before. There is a generation of apostles and prophets that are coming up that are going to be pure-hearted. And then the generals of the faith in the apostolic and the prophetic movement, they are going to see the people who have that gift and have the character to match the gift. Hear me, my friends. Some of you have to make sure that the character... let me just tell you something. Some of you have the gift and the talent and the ability for doors to be open for you right now, but you do not have the character and integrity to match that. Therefore, the full impartation and the full revelation of the kingdom of God has not been given to you yet. Because if and when you receive that full revelation, doors will swing wide open for you. I had a guy tell me recently, he said, how do you get doors to open for you? I said, all I do is I seek God. And they said, well, how do you get extra bookings? I said, I don't look for bookings. I don't look for gigs. I look for God opportunities. In fact, I don't even look for them. they look for me. Because see, when you understand the kingdom of God, you don't have to go after it. It comes after you. Some people say, how do you do financially what you do? I said, I'm attracted. Favor's attracted to me. Finances are attracted to me. When you are doing what God has called you to do, when you have been through the fire two or three times, when you've went through, He will give you the keys of the kingdom. One of the keys is the Word of God. Another key is the Holy Spirit. Another key is integrity. Another key is humility. When you walk in all of that, you will start to get the kingdom of God. You will have so many doors open for you, you can't walk through them all. You will have more opportunities seek you out. You don't have to seek for nothing. It will find you out. Because people want to attach to somebody who's got the favor of God on their life. I was kidding around the other day at my house. I said, man, a favor just comes towards me. My wife said, oh, a favor is attracted to me. And then my 11-year-old Judabu Nene, she said, my name is Favor. And so that's just where it is. I'm telling you, when you do things right, when you do things the right way, things are just gonna start coming towards you. It's just gonna start happening. You don't have to try to make doors open. It's just gonna open up for you. Like I said in Matthew 9, 35 through 38. Man, the disciples were with Jesus. They had been with Him long enough that Jesus knew they were ready for the doors to open up. They were ready to get this kingdom impartation. They were ready for everything to open up. That's why He said, time out, world. I gotta have a Matthew 10, 1 moment. Come here to disciples, let me lay hands, let me slap some oil on you, and let me give you an impartation of the kingdom of God. And then you are going to be ready to go out and preach and teach and then cast out all sickness, all disease, and all devils. You're ready. This is your season. And I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I'm here to tell somebody, this is your season. You've been through the hard moments. You've been through the trials. You've been through the tests. You've been through the tribulations. You've got you an A+. You passed. Now, this is the time that you're about to advance and you're about to move forward. I hope this word challenged you tonight. If this is your season, just write, it's my season. We got some intercessors on here right now, and they're going to pray for you because this is your time. This is your season. And remember, God knows when you're ready. He knows when you're ready. But you better make sure when that door swings wide open that you run through it. You don't have to squint at that door and look at that door and say, oh, is that my door? You're going to know your door. And when it opens, you just better run through it. It's my season. Oh, man, I'm so excited for all you. Well, Lord, I just say in the name of Jesus, I bless every person right now that is typing on here. It is my season and that you bless them. And I just prophesy that it is their season and they're going to walk in everything that you have called them to do. Hey, I'm about to get off. Like I said, we're going to go preach tonight. If this message helps you, go ahead and share this so somebody can come back and watch the replay. If you want more information of anything that we do, go to jojodawson.net. Hey, we got our YouTube channel up and rolling. Go check it out on YouTube. Just look up Jojo Dawson. Boom. Subscribe. There you go. I hope everything is good in y'all's life. Keep going after the Lord. He's about to open doors. He's going to give you just an impartation of authority for the kingdom of God, because it's going to be manifested in the earth. And wouldn't it be fun if He manifested it through you? It is fun. I'm just telling you. You'll have a great day.